Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Brant Larsen. Welcome to the video. This one is about symptoms of an ileocecal valve syndrome, or ICV for short. Now, I think I'm going to make this in a three-part series and then maybe put them all together into one video as well. I know people like a little bit shorter videos. But the ileocecal valve is really, really important. I see this quite often in my office. So what it is, it's at the end of the small intestine, which is called the ileum, and the beginning of the large intestine, which is called the cecum. So right where the small and large intestine come together, there is a valve structure there, okay? And what it does is it controls movement. So obviously you don't want things flowing too quickly from small to large intestine, and you don't want anything coming from the large intestine back up to the small intestine either. That wouldn't be good. So it's between the small and large intestines. So you have two things that can happen. One is that it's stuck open. So it's open more often than it should be, right? And then it's also stuck closed or spastic. Now, some of the symptoms in general for ICV syndromes, dizziness, low back pain, pain in the actual area. Now, I didn't say where it was. So how you find it is you find your belly button and you find like the corner of your hip bone and you draw a line between those two. Right in the middle of that line is typically about roughly where that valve is. It's right where the appendix is as well, because the appendix is right there, kind of by the cecum. So pain in that area, shoulder pain, especially right shoulder pain, nausea, paleness, sudden thirst, bad breath. These are all symptoms of an ileocecal valve syndrome. So you can see they kind of go all over the place, and it can mimic a lot of different things that are happening in the body. Heart fluttering or heart palpitations, migraine headaches, general achiness, so muscles, joints all over the place. And then in women, dysmenorrhea, so pain, endometriosis, and other types of menstrual cycle, uterine type issues as well could be from an ileocecal valve problem. Now, here are some specific stuck open symptoms. So those were all the symptoms in general of what can happen. Here's some stuck open symptoms. Loose bowels. So if it's stuck open, things are flowing too quickly through, obviously loose bowel, so your digestive process is not happening in the timely fashion that it should. People tend to get emotional for some reason. And then vitamin C deficiency. And this occurs because now it's open, so things from the large intestine can come back up into the small intestine more readily. So your body uses up more of its natural resources to fight off the infection. Vitamin C happens to be one of them. So that's why people tend to get a vitamin C deficiency. Stuck closed symptoms. We have constipation. So you have the opposite. Because that valve is more spastic, things aren't flowing through as quickly as they should. So you get constipation. And then you get this the whole thing where all those other symptoms that I mentioned earlier, increased symptoms in the morning. So you're sleeping and you're calm, relaxed and rested, and it increases your symptoms right away in the morning. But once you get moving, once you get doing things, things tend to open up. So it eases with movement or eases throughout the day. So if that picture is you, if your symptoms are worse in the morning but better later in the day, it could be an ileocecal valve issue, along with the lymph flow in general. Once your muscles start pumping and working, your lymph system starts working as well. If you want to learn more, drlarsen.com. Again, I think I'm going to have two more videos on this. One is on prevention and treatment. One will be, I forget the other one, this is symptoms. Causes as well. So I'll probably have a total of three videos on the ileocecal valve syndrome. And so go ahead and look for those. Otherwise, I'll see you soon.